This tutorial will look at the three different types of files that you may interact with within your Google Drive environment. Here I am in my Google Drive account, and in this folder called Tutorials, I have five files of various types. This file, Tutorial, changing your password, is formatted as a Google Doc file. When I click on it, it opens up in Google Docs, and I have the editing toolbar, and I can come here and I can type and make changes, delete, and so forth, all in the cloud. I also have this .pages file. If I click on this .pages file, Google Drive will open it, but it's view only. I can't make any changes to it. Unfortunately, I can't edit this in the cloud. Same thing for this letter to John Doe .doc file. Different view, but still it's view only. And then finally, I have these two files here. If I try to view them, unfortunately, Google Drive says I can't. So what do you do with files like these? Well, this is where Google Drive for Mac or PC really comes into play. Let me switch screens. Here I am in my Google Drive folder. I know I have Google Drive for Mac installed because I have this Google Drive folder installed over here in the window. Here I am in that same tutorials folder, and here are those same five files we were looking at in my Google Drive online. Here's that tutorial file. Notice it's a .gdoc for a Google Doc. And here's that pages file. Remember, I could view it, but I couldn't change it. Well, if I double click it here, the file opens up in pages on my computer, and I can make changes to it. And when I save, it immediately updates the file both on my computer and up in Google Drive because it syncs my files up there. Oh, remember this folder, that file that I couldn't even view at all? Now I can on my Mac. So remember, in Google Drive, you can store a whole bunch of different types of files. Some files you can open and actually change in Google Drive. Other files you can open and only view. And some you can't open at all. But if you have Google Drive for Mac or PC installed, you can do and look at all of your files. This concludes this tutorial.